close your eyes just for a moment and think about what this means to you. Do you see yourself on a hot sand beach, sipping margaritas? Do you see yourself out in the boat with your buddies getting the biggest catch of the day? Or is it about the house, the boat, the bat and the car, and the financial freedom to do whatever you want to do when you want to do it? The thing is, it means something different to each and every one of us. For me, living the dream means doing something you are deeply passionate about. And in that moment, there is nothing on this earth that can stop you. There is nothing that you want more than to be in that moment. I'd like to take you on a little journey. A journey to meet my younger self. As we see her, she is rushing home from school, backpack on her shoulders, flinging open the front door, rushing up the stairs, everything down on the floor, open the drawer, pen, paper, and she's writing. She doesn't know what she's writing about. The pen hits the paper and the words just flow. Most of it is in rhyming verse. Some of it is about distant places, faraway lands, people she's met, never met, may never meet. Doesn't matter, she's writing. We see her again in class. And the assignment is to write a poem about your pet. You can imagine the pen hits the paper, out comes the poem. She stands up from her desk, goes to the teacher. Finished, miss. Go and sit down and write one of your own. You couldn't possibly have written something that quickly. She stops off to her desk, sits down. Can't be bothered. She didn't write another. We see her again in class, reading out loud from passages of the book that they are studying. How she loves reading. She becomes that character. She loses herself within the spaces of the words. She finds herself again with every turn of the page. She is the book. Then she hears there's to be a poetry reading competition. Can you imagine how she felt? Poetry. In her words, she was happier than a hot dog in a bun with all the ketchup and mayonnaise and all the relish that goes with it. She was very excited. It took a while for the results to come through. And when they did so, they were up on the school notice board. She rushed to the board, looked at the names down and up, down and up. Where was hers? It wasn't there. There had to have been a mistake. She went to the teacher and said, "Where's my name?" The teacher said, "No, you've not been chosen." In that very moment, on that spot, her world crushed and crumbled around her. She told herself something that had held her back for over 40 years. But she didn't know she'd done it. What was she to do? I bring you to the here and now as I stand before you here. And a little while ago, I was sick. I was so sick that I couldn't speak for about 5 weeks. And my journey has taken me to help other people. What I do for a living is help people overcome their fears, their phobias, and their blocks to success. couldn't speak. I couldn't help anybody but myself. The tool I use is one of the best self-help tools in the world, without exception. I've been using it for 12 years or more. So I help myself. And in helping myself, I revealed the young me writing the poem in the classroom. I saw the younger me reading the passages in the book. I saw the younger me in front of the teacher being told, you can't do that, you're not selected. And then I was let into the biggest secret. My younger me told me what she had told herself that day. And that was, it was not safe to speak up, and she was not good enough. For 40 years that had followed her and me through life. And since clearing that limiting belief, I joined Toastmasters. I joined National Speakers. I volunteered to be here. And I was told, yes. So here I am. But the story doesn't finish there. I would like to ask you to think about what it is that you may have been told no about. What you are telling yourself no about. What fears are holding you back. And I challenge you to overcome them so that you